We're on Sota Perek Hei, Mishnah Bet, second Mishnah, fifth chapter of Masechet Sota. So the next few Mishnayot, the last Mishnayot in this chapter, from now until the end of the Perek, start with the words Bo Bayom, on that day. On that day, all of the drashot that took place, that are similar, so we learned in the last Mishnah about the Mei Sota, and Rabbi Akiva learned from the word ditma aditma, that asur al baal, asur al boel. She's like asur to her husband, she's asur to her paramour as well. So we're going to learn that on that day, we're going to see which day in a second, that Rabbi Kiva made other drashot as well. The Bar Tunaris says the following. Anytime we learn those words, we read the Mishnah, bo bayom, on that day. What day is it? Bayom sho shivu ad Rabbi Lezer ben Azariah l'nesi'ut. And that's the day that they seated Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah to be the Nasi of the Beit Din, of the Yeshiva. Shenit Rabu Talmidim. That was the day that the Talmidim increased. Shenatnu Bashut Lechol Likarei. Said everyone had permission to enter. This is obviously the famous Gemara in Brachot Daf Kavchet. The story of when they removed Rabbi Gamliel for being too harsh to Rabbi Yoshua. Okay, so the Mishnah says, Tana. The Gemara says, Tana, it's a long story, you should look it up. Otum Hayom, that day, Rebo Bayom, Salku L'Shomer HaPetach, they got rid of the guard at the gate. V'natna Lehem Rishud L'Tamidim L'Kanais, they let the students enter. Sheyar Rabbi Gamliel Machriz V'Omer, Rabbi Gamliel announced and said, Kol Tamid She'en Tocho Kivaro, any day, any student who's outside, inside, is not like he's outside, Lo Yukanais Beit HaMidrash. So he's not allowed to enter the Beit HaMidrash. Rabbi Gamliel was very, very, his entrance requirements were very, very strict. He wouldn't let people in. Hahu Yoma, on that day, itosvu kama safsale, they added many benches. So Rabbi Yochanan said, there's a machlokim now, Yosef ben Yosef Rabbanan. Charamar itosvu arba mea safsale. One said they added 400 benches, and one said 700. Shva mea safsale. 700 benches. And that day, okay, Bo Bayon, the Gemara continues, Ba Yehuda ben Garamoni, there was a number of halachot that Rabbi Gamliel, I guess, didn't want to address, didn't want to deal with. So on that day, they brought up all the halachot that had been tabled by Rabbi Gamliel. They brought them up on that day. Says the Mishnah, Bo Bayon, on that day, not only did they learn about the Sota and the Asur LaBaal, Asur LaBaal, as we learn in Mishnah Aleph, Darash Rabbi Akiva taught. Says in Vayikra, V'chol Kli Cheres Asher Yipol Mehem El Tocho, Kol asher b'tocho yitma. Let's just look at the pasuk. It's basically that. This is Vayikra Yud Aleph Lamed Gimel. Okay. V'chol kli cheres asher yipol mehem. Any earthen vessel wherein fall into asher yipol mehem el tocho. If something tamei falls el tocho inside, kol asher b'tocho yitma v'oto tishbaru. Anything that falls in shall be yitma, shall be unclean, and it shall break. Okay. So if the kli essentially is Tamei. Anything that falls into the Kli becomes Tamei. But the Mishnah says the following, Rabbi Akiva said, Eino Omer Tamei, Ela Yitma. Kol Asher B'tocho, Yitma. Anything that is inside of it, Yitma, will become Tamei. Le Tamei Acheri. Meaning, it's not that whatever's already in the vessel is Tamei, but it makes other things Tamei. Nimeid Al Kikar Sheini, Shemetamei Et Hashlishi. That tells us that a Kikar, a bread that's Tamei, too much Sheini, that it makes, that's Itzvetame, the Shlishi. So let's look for a second. I made you a chart. I made you a thing. So first you have, as we've learned this before, Avi Avoda Tuma is a mate, somebody who's dead. Avatuma is a sheretz, or someone who's nogea, been made, a person. Okay? It's a person who touches the mate. Okay? Rishon is a person who is, well, just for our hanugia, be'av, a person who touches an avatuma. Sheni is ochel, food that touches, or in the same tent, but we're going to talk about touches, rishon. Okay, now what about, is there something called shlishi? So that was the debate in the times of the Tanaim, that this wasn't a done deal. If you have a rishon, okay, in our case, we have a sheretz, an av. The sheretz touch what's called a kli cheres. Let's assume this is a kli cheres. It's an earthenware oven. Inside the oven is a kikar. So the av touches the cheres. That makes it a rishon. Everyone agrees that that's a sheni. The food that touches the rishon is a sheni. But what about our apple? What about my apple? Is my apple now touches my bread? It's what's called a shlishi. Is it a shlishi or not? Comes Rabbi Akiva and says, let's go back to our Mishnah. Says Rabbi Akiva, mitocho yitma, learns from the word yitma, okay? Litamei achim, the made a kikar sheni, that tells us that the kikar sheni, shematamei et ashlishi, that it makes it a shlishi, okay? So there we have klicheres as a rishon, shenitma min asheret shu'ab, ve'ochel bitocho sheni, as we saw in the chart, shitim o hakli, so this is the bread. Oops, let me see if I can find it. The bread is the sheni. What about our apple? Li made al sheni. Shemitameet ashlishi afilu chulin. That's what Rabbi Akiva says. I'm Rabbi Yeshua. Rabbi Yeshua says, Mi galei afraim einecha Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai was dead. Who will uncover the dust from your eyes? Meaning, who will revive you? Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, halavai that you were still alive. Shaita Omer, you said, Ati dor acher litaher kikar shlishi. You thought that kikar shlishi, that this kikar shlishi, or the apple in this case, that touches the sheni, was tahor altogether. Because there's no pasuk that's tameh. But Rabbi Akiva, your student, he brought a pasuk from the Torah that says that the shlishi is tameh. This is a rishon. Bitocho, that becomes sheni from touching. So bitocho, that it should be yitma. So this thing that was bitocho, that was in the klicheres, yitma will make something else tame. And so therefore, Rabbi Akiva says, I prove that the shlishi is tame midoraita. Nonetheless, interestingly, the Bartanura says it, I think, we don't say, ein alacha ki Rabbi Akiva. We don't hold that way. Ein sheni osha shlishi bechulin. This is what we paskin. Sheni does not make shlishi ela bitruma. So shlishi, we paskin is only truma shenaga or kadshim basheni. It's not like lo, not lo ki Rabbi Akiva. And there you have it. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Harab Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Here we go. Have a good day.